In this video, we're going to take a look at division, and specifically that's going to be with a one-digit divisor. Remember, we're talking about a progression of instruction that uses CRA, meaning concrete, representational, and abstract. We are going to focus in on the representation in this video. But in the concrete version, we would be using place value blocks. So for our representations, we're going to be using the square for our hundreds, a line for our tens, and a small circle for our ones. So if I want to do the division problem, 534 divided by 4, how we would represent that with a picture would be to model 534 with our place value blocks. So that's 500s. Three tens. And four ones. Okay, so I've got 500s, three tens, four ones, and that models 534. Now our task is to take this number and divide it by 4, which means we're going to create 4 groups. So I've got 1, 2, 3, 4 groups. And I'm going to divide that up evenly. So I'm going to work through my problem now. I've got hundreds. Can I divide my hundreds into 4 groups? I can if I start through. I can put 4 of those hundreds into groups, and I've got one more left over. So what am I going to do with that? Well, I can't put it into any one group. It has to go in evenly. So if I can't put it in the way it is, then I'm going to have to make an exchange. Okay? I'm going to remove that 100, and I'm going to give myself the equivalent of 10 tens. Okay? Same value. We're just trading in those place value blocks or changing that representation as we draw it. Now that gives me 13 tens, and I can start to divvy up 13 tens across my 4 groups. So maybe I know that I can get 1 in, so we can just start with 1. Now I know I can cross out 4 of those. I can put another 1 in. That would give me 4 more. I've got 5 left, so I can keep going. I can get another 1 in. And now I'm down to 1 more 10. And I can't take that 10 and put it into any one of those groups. Remember, we have to divide it evenly. So I'm going to decompose again. I'm going to take that 10, and I'm going to trade it in for 10 ones. Now I have a total of 14 ones, and I can start to divvy those up. So if I've got 14 ones, one of the things I know is I can put 3 in each group. Three in each group. Don't count that one. It's one of the important parts about representations. If we make a mistake, kids are either going to erase it or they're going to scratch that out. So there's 3, and I can put 3 in this group. There's another one. I can put 3 in this group. And I can put 3 in our last group. And now that I've scribbled out all those 3s that I've put in, I notice that there's 2 more left over. Well, I can't take those 2 and divide them across those 4 groups. So what am I going to do? Well, I can't decompose them either. So what's left? This 2 that are left represent our remainder. So our answer to this problem is going to be, how many did we get in each group? That was 100, 3 tens, and 3 ones, or 133. And we had 2 more left over. So that would be a remainder of 2. Another way to write that would be 133 and 2 that have yet to be divided by 4. So we could also use a mixed number. And then, of course, 2/4 actually reduces, so we could write 133 and 1/2. So we've got a couple different options depending on what we want to use for the answers, where kids are at in the curriculum. But what we see is this representation or this model for division is going to work even when it doesn't divide evenly. Now let's make some connections over to our division algorithm. Remember that it's important to transition students from the representation to the abstract. So how are we going to connect this for students? Well, over here, our first task was to take our 500s and divide them into four groups. Okay? And when we did that, we could put one in each group. So that 100 went in each group. Now, what we typically tell kids is 1 times 4 is 4. Why do we do that? Because we put 1 in each group, but we had 4 groups. So if we have 4 groups, that means that we used up 4 of them. That's why we do that multiplication. And when we subtract, we had 1 left over. And you'll recall up here that we had 1 of those left over. And the issue was we couldn't do that division with that 1 evenly into 4 groups. So remember, we had to actually decompose that 100 into 10 tens. So what we're going to do now, I'm going to drop some lines in here just to help us see this. I'm going to trade that 100 in for 10 more tens. And that would get rid of my 3 tens and give me 13 tens. And you recall up here when we traded in our 10 tens, we had 13 tens. Then the question became, how are we going to take our 13 tens and split them across 4 groups? Okay? And you'll see, remember that we did 3 in each group. So if we can get 3 in each group, 4 times 3 would give us 12. Remember, we multiply it by 4 because we've got 3 in each of the groups, so we've used up 12 of those. That meant that we had 1 more 10 left over. Remember that one that was sticking over here. And what did we do with it? We traded it in for 10 ones. We decomposed that 10 into the next smallest unit. So I'm going to trade in the algorithm over here that 110, and I'm going to give myself 10 more ones, which should give me a total of 14 ones. Then our next task was, how are we going to evenly divide 14 ones across 4 groups? We saw that we could get 3 in each group. And because there are 4 groups, that meant that we used 4 times 3, or 12, of our 1s. We subtract to find out what we would be left with, and there's our 2. Remember our 2 that was hanging on over here that we couldn't divide evenly. And we were done at that point because there was no smaller unit to decompose that into. So this 2 ended up being our remainder. Or remember, we could write it as 2 that has yet to be divided by 4 and reduce that to 1/2. So we could show our answer as 133 remainder 2, 133 and 1/2. And so that's one way that this representation can connect to the abstract way of doing long division.